Hey guys, welcome back to Raise RC. It's time for the preview video of the next upgrade in my /TLGI build series. And this one's not super exciting, but I think it's important. And so what I decided to go with next is basically update and sort of improve the durability of this truck a little bit. /TLGI is a pretty good truck, but it does need a little bit of help. And there are a few things I didn't really quite like with the stock components. And so that's what I'm gonna be talking about today. So the very first thing, you've probably actually already seen this, I never mentioned it, but I'm running aluminum shock caps on the shocks. Ooh, those are some dirty shocks, man. Gotta clean those up. The stock plastic shock caps tend to kind of flex and pop off at inopportune times, you know, in a big crash or whatever. So I've actually upgraded those, you know, from day one. That was an experience I had with my Stampede 4x4, and so that's been on there for a while now. But the other things I'm looking to upgrade are basically on the hexes. It comes with these plastic hexes, which are really not very grippy. They can kind of round out your wheel hexes a little bit. So STRC makes a nice set of wheel hexes. These actually have set screws that kind of hold them on. So I don't really like the Traxxas ones because they don't really stay on the axles that well. But these with the set screw, I've had good success with in the past. So STRC aluminum wheel hexes, that's the next upgrade. Along with aluminum wheel hexes, I like running basically CR-rated lock nuts. So Techno makes a set, TKR 1213. These are flanged lock nuts with also these really sort of aggressive serrations on the wheel hexes. You know, they're not even, they basically anodize the wheel hexes and then basically machine them again so that you get extra grip, extra bite into your wheel so the wheels don't fall off. You know, running a little more power, you definitely want to make sure the wheels don't fall off, they don't round out the hexes. And so that those two together basically help that. And the last thing basically are the front caster blocks. So basically kind of one of the well-known issues with the /TLGI is the front caster blocks are made of plastic. They flex a little bit. They can kind of bend your hinge pins and stuff. So there's a bunch of companies that actually make aluminum caster blocks. STRC makes some, Traxxas makes some, Hot Racing, I'm sure others. But the ones, you know, I decided to go with are basically these Proline ones. And the reason for that is basically they're not only aluminum, but they actually have multiple basically mounting holes for your caster blocks. So you can see it's got two mounting holes instead of just one, a little more adjustment. So they all cost around $20. This is the Proline version. I think it's the only one that really has adjustable camber link location. So I still go with these guys. That should have a little more durability up front. Overall, I really haven't had too many issues with the Slash. It's been a very durable truck, but you know, running plastic wheel hexes in my book is kind of a no-no. I always run aluminum wheel hexes, but now that we've kind of addressed, you know, the main issues with the chassis, with the suspension arms and stuff, I think it's time now to actually upgrade to some aluminum parts just for durability. I'm not really into the bling, but these things I think will help out basically improving the durability of the truck. So anyways, that's it. That's the preview of the next upgrade. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And definitely like, subscribe if you haven't already. Throw down some comments. Let me know what you think. If you have suggestions for other upgrades, I'd like to hear them. You know, I definitely have a plan, an idea of what I'm gonna do next, but definitely there may be things I've overlooked. So thanks for watching and take care. Look for a review of these parts soon. Thanks, bye.